And the chairman, Imo COVID-19 Task Force, Maurice Iwu, said contact tracing of active cases is still on so as to ensure they are taken to isolation centers for proper medical examination. He gave the assurance while briefing the media on the activities of the task force. He said that out of 86 coronavirus cases in Imo State, only 12 were active and the patients are receiving treatment at two different locations in the state. The chairman said the state has not recorded any death from the virus. He appealed to citizens of the state to always inform the task force on suspected cases for immediate action. We're now joined by Dr. Gabriel Nwala, Chairman, Christian Medical and Dental Association of Nigeria, CMDA, Abia State Chapter. Thank you very much for joining us on the news.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
Now, the WHO says COVID-19 situation is worsening worldwide and is warning against complacency. Are we becoming complacent in the fight against the pandemic in Nigeria?
Well, I think we are. Currently, there has been a lockdown in several states, and the use of face masks by Nigerians are being played down, and a lot of Nigerians still feel that this whole COVID thing is a scam. You know, our churches have reopened, having services as though nothing is happening, and this might not be a very good decision, as it were. So we may witness a rise in the number of cases. And in addition to that, some states have not really welcomed this idea of testing their
as much as they should.
Much as they should. And this may give a wrong impression that there are no cases in those states. Meanwhile, there are actually higher number of cases as an NCDC has currently been announcing. A case in point is Abia State that started massive testing recently. In the past week, number of 100 tests per day was done, and we saw the figures that came out positive. So I think it's not yet
El Dorado, so to speak.
Yes, it's not yet time for us to,
All right. The total number of recoveries in Nigeria is said to have exceeded 4,000. But some say it isn't really cheery news, considering the current total number of infection we have. What do you say to that?
Well, I think that figure is actually, should actually be multiplied by 10, because, just about 27,000 tests have been done so far, and this is not even up to 10% of our population. So what that figure may not really be a good representation of what is actually happening.
Gombe State Task Force on COVID-19 on Tuesday said the 9 government officials who tested positive for the virus are opting for home isolation. Are you worried about this? Is it too early to be embracing the home option, perhaps?
Okay, well, it depends on the nature of their healthcare facility there in Gombe State. If the healthcare sector is actually overstressed and is unable to handle these COVID-19 cases, I think what they've done, it's welcome. Even in advanced economies, that's exactly what they actually, do over there. It's what I would only want to, find out is, whether these one, the people that are opting for home isolations, whether they are symptomatic and the nature of symptoms they're having. If they're having minor symptoms, there's nothing wrong with that. But if the nature of their symptoms warrants isolation in a healthcare facility, then I don't think it's a good decision on their part.
I want to take your thought on the seemingly unending conflict between the Kogi state government and the NCDC. Just yesterday, we heard the government has ordered all level 1 to 10 civil servants to resume by Monday. What is the conversation about the situation in the medical community that you belong?
Well, I don't think that was a wise decision. I say this because they've not even allowed the NCDC to test, people. If there has been enough testing and, they've found out that the number of positive cases are not much, or the curve has actually flattened, and this decision comes up, one would have said, okay, it was a wise one. But when they've not even tested their people, we might be heading for a major problem, in the nearest future if they take that line.
Do you have any update on where we are on our quest to contribute towards advancing the cause of getting a vaccine? There's been conversation here and there, but from your unique position in the medical profession, where are we?
Okay, recently, the federal government announced that, that five states and the federal capital territory, will be part of a WHO pioneer clinical trials, known as solidarity trials. The states are Lagos, Ogun, Kano, Kaduna, and Sokoto states, with the FCT. This is spearheaded by WHO, and this, should also be welcome, because anything that will help reduce the morbidity and mortality of COVID-19 and pandemic should be welcome. And Nigeria is not in isolation. Other countries like UK have already started their trials on some candidate vaccines. So I think it's a welcome development by the federal government.
Dr. Gabriel, thank you very much for joining us on the news.
Thank you for having me.